गौर प्रेमानंदे हरि हरि ज्ञान तिमिरं दत्ते ज्ञानंजन शलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकाय सदालये कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय नमो नमः। संसार दुख जलदस्य पतितस्य काम क्रोधादिनक्रमकृतवलीकृतस्य दुर्वासनस्य निगृहितस्य निराशयस्य चैतन्य चंद्र मम देही सदावलम्बम्। चैतन्य चंद्र मम देही सदावलम्बम्। जयतां सुततंगुर्मम मंदवतीर्गति मत्सर्व सदा मृज श्रीराधा मदन मोहन। भक्त्या विहीनाय अपराध लक्ष्य क्षिप्तस्य कामादितरंग मध्ये कृपामयी तं शरणं प्रपन्न वृन्दे नमस्ते चरणारविन्दम्। श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद। बोलो हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। लाउडली हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। सो टुडे इज वेरी ऑस्पिशियस डे। One of our Guru Varga, Acharya in our line, in the line of Srila Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, one of his very dear and prominent disciples, Mitarila Pravesh Om Vishnu Parasotashad, Shishimad Bhakti Sirup Siddhanti Goswami Maharaj, today is his appearance day. Appearance day? Disappearance day. Okay. So today is disappearance day. The appearance and disappearance of Vaishnavas, they are in same line. Generally in this world, when there is any birth in the family, people celebrate the appearance, the birth. But if someone leaves the family, then everyone lament and very sad. But in terms of Acharyas and Vaishnavas, their appearance and disappearance is of the same line. Appearance, we all know the meaning of appearance. But disappearance is also termed as appearance. As Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada, once upon a time, he gave one lecture on the disappearance day of his Guru Maharaj, Sri Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj. And he started saying that even though today is disappearance day of my Guru Maharaj, but I'm finding this is appearance of Guru Maharaj. Why? Jayashree, understanding this? Because you are translating. Okay, I'm going slow. Is anyone there to do the Spanish part? Who is doing Spanish? Jai Govinda. एनीवे भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती ठाकुर प्रभुपाद हिज गुरु महाराज इज गौर किशोर बाबाजी महाराज. सो वंस अपॉन अ टाइम ऑन द डिसअपीयरेंस डे ऑफ गौर किशोर बाबाजी महाराज श्रील भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती ठाकुर प्रभुपाद व्हाइल ही स्पीकिंग व्हाइल ही स्टार्टेड हिज लेक्चर ही सेड इवन दो Today's disappearance of my Guru Maharaj. But I am taking this as an appearance of my Guru Maharaj. Why? Because I am hearing the glories of my Guru Maharaj from so many Vaishnavas. And when I am hearing the qualities, the glories of my Guru Maharaj, the appearance of my Guru Maharaj manifesting in my heart. The appearance of the qualities of our Gurudev in the heart is also known as appearance. Try to understand this. This is something transcendental. In material world, unless a person appears in front of us, comes right in front of us, we don't believe the appearance system. But in spiritual world, while hearing again, again and again the qualities of Gurudev, the qualities of Acharyas, Vaishnavas, qualities of Krishna, qualities of Radharani, by hearing again and again, what we are doing, the appearance of them in our heart, by hearing their qualities, the appearance of Gurudev, the appearance of Acharyas, the appearance of Krishna, Radharani, Mahaprabhu. There is no other way to make that appearance comes to the heart unless we hear their qualities, their contributions, and their glories. So what happens generally on the disappearance day of Acharya? We speak about their qualities. We speak about their contributions. We speak about their exemplary behavior. We speak about their idols. And what happens? We get inspired. We get enthusiastic to follow the same standard. That means the appearance of that Acharya already there in the heart. Because there is an inspiration to follow the example. That's called appearance. The spiritual world is not something which is physical appearance or physical proximity. It has to do with appearance in the heart. Therefore, Shri Goswami Pad said, Anarpitam Charim Chirat कारुण्य अवतीन कलो समर्पित उन्नतुजरसाम स्वभक्ति श्रियम हरिपुर सुंदर दुति कदंबा संदिकिता सदा हृदय कंदरेशु स्फुरितो वै सचिनंदन. मे दैट सचिनंदन गौर हरि अपियर इन द इनर कोर ऑफ माई हार्ट अपियर इन अर हार्ट नॉट ओनली एक्सटर्नल अपीयरेंस but also the important is appearance in the heart, both. Understand? So, Shri Bhakti Sirup Siddhanti Goswami Maharaj, very prominent Acharya, a very dear disciple of Srila Prabhupada and prominent Acharya of the Gaudiya Vaishnava. Uh, if we visit any of his center, we find some speciality there. So let me start from this point. He has his center in Jagannath Puri, in Navadvip Dham, also in Vrindavan. And what we see in the center, his style. In the center, we will see, if we go, we see there is no paints on the wall. There are paintings on the wall. There is not a single corner left with any different kind of paint, red, green, yellow, etc. Every time we see paintings. Paintings, or we say diagrams, if you don't understand, okay, painting. Of Radha Krishna, Krishna killing demons, Krishna lifting Govardhan hills, Krishna having Julan pastime, spring pastime, and so many others. All Krishna pastime. And then Mahaprabhu pastime. Mahaprabhu taking sannyas, Mahaprabhu as Nimai, Mahaprabhu in the water, in the Ganga, Mahaprabhu as sannyasi, dancing in front of Rath Yatra, all this painting. And painting of Srila Prabhupada, his pastimes. So in other words, the whole wall, the all walls around what we see is all colorful. It's all colorful. So is it just like that, or is there any particular reason why he did like this? Yes. The activities of acharyas have always some specific reason. He didn't want it to paint his temple, his center, with different paints to just gratify the senses. The eye says, oh, this red paint is very good. Or this yellow paint is very good. Or this blue one looks good. Or this combination is very good. This is only to satisfy the eyes. But acharyas are not there to satisfy any senses, to gratify any senses. Their role is to yayatma suprasiddhati. Not for any entertainment of eyes, nose, ears, touch, etc. But to give nourishment to the soul. So, sarve punsa paro dharmo yatha bhakti adhokshaje etuki apatihita jayatma suprasiddhati. Only one dharma. Only one dharma, duty of the soul, is to worship Krishna, whose name is Adhokshaj. One of the name of Krishna is Adhokshaj. Adhokshaj means one who can't be understood by senses. One who is beyond senses. You can't see, we can't see him. We can't hear him. We can't touch him. We can't understand him. So if we can't do all these things, then why we have to worship him? And another question is, if it can't be seen by the senses, then why we are doing so much practice? Why are we doing chanting and all? Why? Because Atashi Krishna Namadi Na Bhaved Graji Indriyai Sevan Mukhe Hi Jivado Swayamme Surate Manana. Krishna cannot be perceived with the senses. But if he wants to highlight himself, if he wants to, our senses can see him, touch him, hear him, he can do this. And how is possible? Only by serving. सेवन मुखे ही जीवा दो बाय सर्विंग हिम बाय एंगेजिंग दिस टंग इन चैंटिंग हिज नेम एंड डेडिकेटिंग वन लाइफ इन हिज सर्विस सेवन मुखे ही जीवा दो स्वयं में सुरते मना देन कृष्णा रिफ्लेक्ट इन द सेंसेस वन कैन सी हिम वन कैन स्मेल हिम वन कैन टेस्ट हिम वन कैन टच हिम reflect on the senses. That's why his name is Adhokshaj. So Srila Bhakti Siddhu Siddhanti Goswami Maharaj, his color, his mart, his center, all walls are so colorful because he has this idea there is no scope for any sense enjoyment, thinking this color is good, that color is good. Wherever you see, always you see the past tense of Krishna, which reminds you the past tense of Krishna, which reminds you the past tense of Mahaprabhu, which reminds you the past tense of Prabhupada, all Acharyas. Our eyes are only meant to see them. And by seeing them, remembering the past tense. Anyone who coming from outside as a guest to visit the center, what the person will see around everywhere is saying, oh, past tense and past tense. That means this is an embassy of Golok Vrindavan. And this is what's happening in Golok Vrindavan. All times, what's happening? Just past tense. No time passed there. Their time passes, past time. This is how they're passing their time. Time pass with past time. This is how it's happening there. So, anyone, any visitor enters the temple, he see around all the past time. So that means he wanted to say, in our center, we have no other business, but only one business, that is to glorify Krishna, to remember Krishna. That is only our business. And if you have any other business, then we are sorry, we can't help you. We can't serve you. If you really want devotion, if you want to be with Krishna, we are always there to help you. That's for the visitors. But those who are residents of the center, for them, this is a lesson. Yeah. That we are not surrendered our life to the center for any other work, only remembering Krishna. So practice, practice, and practice, and practice. So, the quality of a Vaishnava, the quality of Acharya reflects by the activities. It is not just simply that he don't have any paints, but he has paintings on the wall. This mood of Acharya reflects in the form of paintings, of his ideas reflect on in his actions. Understand? This is how. This is one point. And then other is fearless seeker, very bold seeker. No matter if there is big audience of thousands of people, this is remarkable. As you all might have heard this, while he was in Bangladesh, which was in the territory of India in those days, now Bangladesh is a separate country, but many of our acharyas, Sri Narottam Thakur, my Guru Maharaj, Sri Bhakti Rahita Madhava Goswami Maharaj, and so many of Mahaprabhu's associates, they got birth in Bangladesh, which was in India. Okay, so Srila Prabhupada sent him Bangladesh for preaching. Along with Srila Bhakti Raksha Sridhar Maharaj, Srila Bhakti Dait Madhav Goswami Maharaj for preaching. And big crowd, big audience, thousands of people there. And he used to speak very boldly. And he went to that far extent, speaking directly about a personality who is very famous in India, especially amongst Bengalis. He spoke very harsh words because he was diverting people from following the pure bhakti to something which is just ordinary, some rituals. Srila Bhakti Swarup Siddhanti Goswami Maharaj spoke direct to them without considering that what will happen, without considering how the audience going to react. No consideration, but he just spoke direct. And hearing this, people used to worship him like Bhagwan, like a big guru. And by hearing Srila Swarup Siddhanti Goswami Maharaj speaking like this, everyone stood up, started shouting, and made him quiet. Stop this! Stop this! And the whole program was destroyed. Everyone just became upset. And they all complained to police, they complained to magistrate. Because the program was assigned for a few days. But it just all got totally ruined in just one day. Everything. Now, Srila Bhakti Raksha Sridhar Goswami Maharaj and Srila Bhakti Dait Madhav Goswami Maharaj, they went to magistrate and requested him, please allow us to continue our program. And we promise, nothing going to happen. There will be no protest from the audience. Hearing the sweet words of these two acharyas, magistrate allowed them. Okay, I'm allowing you to continue your program, but don't allow that speaker to speak again. Only on this point, I'm allowing you. Then Srila Sridhar Goswami Maharaj said, okay, we promise you, that speaker will not speak again. We will speak on his behalf. And I promise you, nothing is going to happen. I will settle down everyone and I will pacify everyone. Hearing this, magistrate granted permission. And the next evening, everyone was ready to speak back, to shout back. If they ever come up with this criticism of this big person, everyone was ready. But Srila Bhakti Raksha Sridhar Goswami Maharaj and Srila Bhakti Dait Madhav Goswami Maharaj, they spoke so politely. But the true Siddhanta, the true words which Srirup Siddhanti Goswami Maharaj wanted to speak, they spoke, but in a different word. And you can hear this in this book, My Beloved Masters, with Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Goswami Maharaj. He wrote this book, he spoke this book, and we have this audio file also. So on the appearance day, a disappearance of acharyas, we should hear this. If we can't read, we should hear this. But if we have book, we should read this to honor them. So in this way, Srila Bhakti Raksha Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, he reconciled, saying that we, followers of Mahaprabhu, we follow Rupa Goswami, we follow Sanatan Goswami, we follow Jeev Goswami. We don't follow any person who just come saying that, oh, my sampradaya or my beliefs are bona fide. Without any evidence, we don't believe them. And he gave so many examples. And then he said one thing. The person who was criticized, he believed and he preached. The word jiva means only human beings. The word jiva, living entity, means only human beings. Whereas we say jiva, living entity, means all, everyone, even animals, even birds, even aquatic, and even human beings. That means one should not kill them, one should be compassionate to them. But this person who's running a sampradaya, he's only considering the word jiva means human beings. That's why he allows, he even allows fish and other animals in the sampradaya. That means the followers, they are allowed to eat all meat and etc. Meat, fish, etc. They are allowed. Which is totally bogus. By hearing this, the audience, they got so much enlightened and they glorified how respectfully and in polite way Srila Bhakti Raksha Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, he reconciled this and he harmonized that no protest came from the audience and they liked this. They liked this so much. This is how the qualities of Srila Bhakti Swarup Siddhanti Goswami Maharaj. Speaking fearless, very bold. And another about book printing. He wrote he wrote the commentary on Vedanta Sutra, which was so difficult to write. The commentaries. Vedanta Sutra is written by Srila Ved Vyasji. For Srila Bhakti Swarup Siddhanti Goswami Maharaj, he wrote commentaries. And that was required. All Godbrothers glorified him for this work. Because this book was not present. And I also heard that many professors in universities, they were so impressed to see this. And they wanted to add this as a subject in the university. They wanted to add this. But when they saw this book, they didn't like the idea that the pictures of acharyas are there. Means the picture of Srila Prabhupada, picture of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. All these pictures were there. This is our standard. Because we pay obeisances to our acharyas. We pray to them before we start reading any book. Or when we open a book. So, a message came from the university. We want to introduce this book as our subject. So, Bhakti Swarup Siddhanti Goswami Maharaj became very happy. And, oh, in this way, many people will come to know about Gaudiya Math. And the preaching of Prabhupada will be spread everywhere. The preaching of Gaudiya Math will be spread everywhere. So, that's something wonderful, they said. He said, but they said there is only one objection, the university people said. You know, we can't just put any pictures inside the book because we are trying to introduce as a subject. We can't do partiality. So if you take out the pictures from the book, then we will introduce this as the subject in our university. When Sri Bhakti Swarup Siddhanti Goswami Maharaj heard this, he said, no way. I don't want these pictures. I cannot take out these pictures from the book. Because of the mercy of these acharyas I'm seeing in this picture, I'm able to write this. Because of the mercy of my Guru Maharaj, Srila Prabhupada, I'm able to write this. The potency invested in me by him, I'm able to write this. I'm no one to do this. All credits to them, all my Guru Vargas, all my Acharyas. And that's why I'm sorry, I can't take these pictures out. So imagine, his name and fame would have been spreaded everywhere in the university. Because people will read this book and they will see who is the commentator. But devotees, they never want their credit. They want to give credit to their Gurudev. So on any point of keeping them aside or to neglect them, it's not considered as bona fide in our Gaudiya Vaishnava line. All the time we see credit given to one's Gurudev. Sri Chaitanya Chaitamrita, written by Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami. When Kaviraj Goswami writing there, a granth likha hai mor madan mohan. I cannot write this book. It is inspired by and written by and spoken by Sri Madan Mohan. Madan Mohan from Vrindavan. When Kaviraj Goswami went to see Sri Madan Mohanji and asked permission, a garland fell from his neck. Permission granted. And the author, Sri Kaviraj Goswami, writing Chaitanya Chaitamrita, the past tense of Mahaprabhu, he himself is saying, I don't know how I'm writing this. I'm not writing this. Who's writing this? A granth likhaye mor Madan Mohan. I'm just like a parrot, repeating the words. But actually, who's writing this? Direct Krishna is writing this. Direct Madan Mohan is writing this. And at the end of each every chapter of Chaitanya Chaitamrita, what we see? A similar shloka, a similar verse. Roop Raghunath Pade Jarash Chaitanya Chaitamrita Kahe Krishna Das. Desiring the lotus feet of Roop Raghunath, Krishnadas, he is addressing himself. I am able to write this book called Chaitanya Chaitamrita. I am no one to write this. It is just I got this information from Sri Raghunath Das Goswami. I am able to write this. Our Srila Gurudev also, he used to say this. I can't do so much book work. I can't translate so many books. It is my Guru Maharaj who is investing Shakti, potency in me. It is he who is giving so much energy and inspiration. Otherwise, I cannot do anything. So this is our system. Always credit to acharyas. And actually, this is not something artificial. This is something true. No one can do any seva, any service to Krishna. No one can even chant the name of Krishna if the mercy and the compassion of acharyas falls on us. Can't do anything. First of all, the inspiration, then the potency to fulfill that inspiration. Everything in spiritual world, spiritual life, it's all by the mercy of Gurudev. Guru Kripahi Kevalam. Learn this. This is the mantra. And we should never forget this. We should write this on our wall, seeing every day, to make our mind, the foolish mind, remember this. It is not me that I'm able to sing, I'm able to speak, I'm able to write, I'm able to do any service. Guru Kripahi Kevalam. This is the mantra. Every day we have to remember this. Because it's very easy to forget this. We forget this. All these qualities supplied by Gurudev. But when we start misuse these qualities, then the supply is stopped. Misusing means I'm the doer. I'm doing this. Oh, I learned this. That's why I'm speaking or I'm singing. But everything is finished there. But if every time you're thinking, my Gurudev is doing this, and I'm just a puppet, I'm just a parrot, he's making me dance, he's moving me. So Guru Kripahi Kevalam. This is the mantra. A disciple always have to keep in the mind. So in this way, we pay obeisances. We remember on this day, Shri Bhakti Siddhanti Goswami Maharaj, for his unparalleled, wonderful contribution in the Gaudiya Sampradaya, as other acharyas also contributed a lot to come to make us to this point of understanding what is our goal of life. From every acharya, we learn something or the other. From every acharya, preaching, practicing, and as I said, the mood of acharya reflects in their actions. So if they, just for simple example, painting the wall. Painting on everywhere in the walls. What is this? It's the mood of acharya. Reflects in this way. Bhakti Shri Siddhanti Goswami Maharaj, he always used to accompany with his senior god brother, Bhakti Vivek Bharati Goswami Maharaj. Srila Gurudev used to speak this point. So Srila Bhakti Vivek Bharati Goswami Maharaj was his senior god brother. And once upon a time, he chastised him. He beat him. Beat him? I don't know, but chastised him very badly. And then everyone thought, now Bhakti Shri Siddhanti Goswami Maharaj will not anymore accompany his senior god brother, getting so much chastised by him. But he still wanted to be in his association. And when devotees ask him, why are you not giving up his company? Because he chastised you very badly. And he replied, he chastised me, this is true, but for my welfare. Because he see, he wants to bless me. He wants you to be compassionate to me. He wanted me to learn. That's why he chastised me. The chastisement of Vaishnavas, it's not something artificial or out of any envious. The chastisement of Vaishnavas is a kind of blessing. But a person who is a proper recipient to understand this, can understand. Otherwise, people, they don't understand this theory. They don't understand this feeling. The chastisement of Narad Muni, Sri Naradji, to the sons of Kuber, Nal Kuber Manigrib, What is that chastisement? Cursing him. I understand. In this world, if you curse someone, say so many things, you think that person will speak to you ever in your life? No. Forget about it. Forget about it. And especially, okay, we accept the chastisement from Gurudev. We understand, okay, that's bona fide. Because he's Gurudev, whatever he says is correct. If he's chastising us, we have to hear that. And as I was telling a few days back, even if we are right, and we know Gurudev is not understanding, and even if he's chastising, be quiet and hear. Be quiet and hear. That's the etiquette. Later he will understand. Just like a very practical example. One godbrother of Srila Gurudev, he is still present. Very tall, strong. And once upon a time, he did some mistake in hosting some devotees in Navadvip Dham Parikrama. Gurudev came to know this from some sources. And he called upon him. I was there personally, I was massaging him. I was massaging his head after the Harikatha evening class. And he came in the room. Gurudev was, you know, he was tired and his eyes were closed. He came in room and he said, Maharaj, I heard you calling me. Is there something? And Srila Gurudev opened his eyes and he gave him very big slap. We all devotees in the room, what happened? And one slap and then one hit here, one hit here. And then Gurudev, because he was very strong, Gurudev in his advanced age, while Gurudev hit him, Gurudev's hand got hurt and he did this. And we all stopped him. Relax, relax. We started massaging him. And Gurudev said, go away. Go away from here. How can you do such mistakes? So crying and weeping, he left the room without saying a single word. He accepted that chastisement. And Gurudev's anger mood is just like a bubble. It comes, and after 5 minutes, finish. It's like this. So next day, he came in the room. He came again without calling. He came in the room and Gurudev said, hey, listen, you're my godbrother. Yesterday I did mistake. I hit you yesterday. I'm not supposed to do that. So I did a mistake, Gurudev said. And just when he heard this, he started crying. And he kept his head on Gurudev's lotus feet. Forgiveness. So he started crying. He said, Maharaj, and he, because his godfather Gurudev, no so much reservation, he just took hold the hand of Srila Gurudev in his hand, started massaging his hand. He said, no, I'm not worried that you chastise me or you beat me. You can beat me as much as you can. I'm not worried. But I was thinking whole night, whole day, by hitting me, you got hurt in your hands. You got hurted on your hands. I'm sorry for that. You must be having pain. Let me massage you. And he started massaging Gurudev. So, if Gurudev is chastising, and we know we are right, still, the etiquette say quiet. Hear this. hear him and let him chastise you. Later he will come to know by himself who's right, who's wrong. Not that Gurudev is wrong, but the source who's giving information, he might be wrong. And then Gurudev acknowledged this quality. That even I know this person was right and I was wrong chastising him, but he or she, whoever it is, he took it as my words. He took it my chastisement very politely. That means tolerance is there. I've seen so many examples staying with Gurudev like this. So many examples. Therefore, we need maturity. I'm always saying this. Maturity, maturity, that's the mahamantra. If we are not mature, we can speak so much. Oh, I know this, I know that, I know this, I know that. Yes, philosophically, one can be strong. But many people, they speak philosophy just with their mind, what they understand. Not even backed by any evidence. By book, scriptures, or by any acharya. Just speaking with whatever they understand, that I perceive this, I understood like this. That's not our system. Shiji Goswami, he told there are 10 pramans, 10 evidences. Anuman, Upuman, Ehi, Ityadi, there's so many. Some other time, I will go details to that. But in our line, we don't accept all this. Anuman. Anuman means guess. Upman means something similar. And we conclude, oh yes, this is our point. This is my philosophy. These are not considered bona fide. What is considered bona fide? Shabd praman. Shabd. Shabd means evam paramparam praptam, Bhagavad Gita says. What I heard from my acharyas, that's the only bona fide statement. That's everything. Shabd praman. Praman means evidence. Shabda means words. The philosophy which I'm hearing from my Gurudev, from my acharyas, only that is bona fide. And I'm no one to add or subtract anything from that for my better understanding. No, we have to accept as it is. But acceptance of that also needs maturity. And how maturity comes? By seeing the dealings of acharyas. By seeing the dealings of acharyas. Then maturity comes. Otherwise, I can just say whatever I feel good. Yeah. I'll just say whatever I feel good. As it happened, Srila Swami Maharaj, there were some press media people arguing with him in America. And they always, there were, the way of their style of speaking is, you know, they say, Swamiji, they say, means scientists say, doctors say, they say. And Srila Swami Maharaj got irritated and say, you say, they say, I say, we say. You say, they say, I say, we say. We are following our acharyas, Shabd Praman. That's called maturity, Shabd Praman. How much we are mature enough to understand the scriptures, the words of scriptures, our shastras. How much we can understand this? And that's the reason those people who got confused think that, few days back we were hearing Rupa Goswami Pad told Jiva Goswami to go away from me. So those who started saying this, that Rupa Goswami banished or abandoned Jiva Goswami or rejected him, they were not ordinary people. They knew scriptures. Not ordinary people were saying this. From Vrindavan, these people, learned people saying this, but they were not able, mature enough to understand this dealing between Rupa Goswami and Jiva Goswami. One can even get confused with the past tense of Mahaprabhu. If you're not surrender to anyone to understand that, then the same thing will come. They say. You say, they say. I say, we say. Same philosophy will apply here. Therefore, we should not feel shy to accept guidance or to accept someone who knows scriptures, who learns scriptures under guidance of Gurudev, under guidance of Acharya. There is no harm accepting their guidance and to learn from them rather than just my own points. You know, it's like for example, I can speak 2 hours, 3 hours, one subject. And at the end of 3 hours, Gurudev just speak cross. Everything you said, just with your mind. What you understood with your mind. But you feel good with your mind. And your mind is not authority. Gurudev can immediately cross. Sometimes we are writing something for days and days and days. And after that, showing to Gurudev, he cross. A cross. X. Huh? Everything cross. Yes. Because even in the scriptures, even in our books, we need guidance to understand what is written there. Otherwise, I conclude with my mind, you conclude with your mind. That's not the conclusion. Can we digest this? I was speaking this point already. The disciplines of Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Goswami Maharaj. Can we digest this? Mahaprabhu said Sankirtan to be a noise, to be just a noise. Or the other word, Sankirtan to be disturbance. Can we digest this? Mahaprabhu saying this? Sankirtan is a disturbance. No. Can we believe Mahaprabhu can say this? Yes, he said this. He said Sankirtan is disturbance. Oh? What is this? My neighbor used to say this. Sankirtan is disturbance. Mahaprabhu also saying same thing. Chand Kaji, Muslim. Chanting Allah. They say Sankirtan is disturbance. And many people say Sankirtan is disturbance. Devotees doing Harinam on the beach here and there. And all these people enjoying on the beach, they say, what is this nonsense? This disturbance. And well, when they are in their cars with the with the music on, disturbing everyone. That is not disturbance. But Sankirtan is disturbance. We all come across people like that, right? What to speak of Western world, even in India. Even in India, in cities, when we have centers there in the locality, in city, the neighborhood, always someone or the other comes with a complaint. Complaint to police, complaint. So many, I've seen so many cases. Disturbance. Saying Sankirtan is disturbance. Mahaprabhu said Sankirtan is disturbance. Huh? I can't digest this. Then where is that maturity level to understand this? Sankirtan is disturbance. Mahaprabhu, exactly the same word he said. Kolahal, disturbance. But we have to understand this from Acharya like Srila Bharati Goswami Maharaj. When and why he said Sankirtan is disturbance? For what reason he said Sankirtan is disturbance? So if we read Chaitanya Charitamrita, right? Look at me. Reading Chaitanya Charitamrita. Sankirtan disturbance? From tomorrow I'm not doing Sankirtan. Because Mahaprabhu said this. This is what I, this is how we conclude with our understanding. Even though it is written in our books, then what is maturity level? For maturity level, we have to understand this from our acharyas. So Srila Bharati Goswami Maharaj explained this. When Mahaprabhu said Sankirtan is disturbance, not every time. Every time he is always saying. What is saying? Prabhu agya pai mage veksha. Bolo Krishna bhajo Krishna karo Krishna sheksha. Mahaprabhu saying. Suno suno Nityanan, suno Haridas. Amar agya sarvat karo prachar. Prati griye griye karo ei bhikha. Bolo Krishna, bhajo Krishna, karo Krishna shiksha. O Nityanand Haridas, go each and every house and collect this bhiksha. Collect this alms from them. What? Bolo Krishna, bhajo Krishna means Sankirtan. Prabhu kahe kahilam iha maha mantra. Iha jape giya gari sarva nirvanda. Iha hoite sarva siddhi haive savara. प्रतिखन बोले इते विधि नहीं यारा की भोजने की शयने की वजागराने प्रभु कहे कही लाम इह महामंत्र इह जपे गिया करी सर्वनिर्बंध महाप्रभु सेड दिस इज द महामंत्र चैंट दिस एंड बाय चैंटिंग दिस वन कैन वेरी इजली कैन एक्वायर ऑल स्पिरिचुअल क्वालिटीज ऑल द गुड क्वालिटीज to advance in spiritual life. Right? This is Mahaprabhu's statement. Jare dekho tare kaho, Krishna upadesh, amar agya guru haiya taro idesh. All these statements, everywhere Mahaprabhu is saying, Sankirtan, Sankirtan, Sankirtan. The appearance of Mahaprabhu happened with a Sankirtan. Mahaprabhu got birth. What everyone was doing in Mayapur Navdeep, it was eclipse. Everyone was doing Sankirtan. Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol. Mahaprabhu himself dancing. Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol. Jumping high. Udanda Nipte. Dancing in ecstasy. Hari Bol, Hari Bol. Sankirtan. But I read Mahaprabhu saying Sankirtan is kolaha. Means a disturbance. You know why? Then we have to take shelter of acharyas to understand this. Let me keep this suspense for today. And we'll tell tomorrow. Yeah? sometimes keeping some suspense is okay. When a person gets thoughtful, what is the answer? What is the answer? What is the answer? So I'm not going to tell today. Let me keep like this. Tomorrow we're going to hear. Very interesting. Gaur Premanande Hari Hari Bol. Hare Krishna. We'll hear tomorrow. More on this.